Happy Monday all, my name is David Pegler. This is your pre-loan and outlook for March the 23rd, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you, the purpose of this exercise is education. This is non-alert service. I'm not going to make any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what I will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good profitable trade plans. Please keep in mind, trading is always a very risky business, especially when you're leveraged 100 to 1 and sometimes more. Occasionally, this leverage works for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, it's going to work against you. So do not trade real money until you have a proven track record of success on a demo. All right, guys. Well, we kind of got this one nailed down. I got you looking at the daily chart for Euro. And if you remember, we were calling for a little pullback on Friday, and that's what we got. We didn't come back to quite as deep as I wanted us to. We did return to the DAR 21, which from an EMA standpoint was our downside target, excuse me, but from a FIB point it wasn't. So today, if I just zoom you way in, just based on the same kind of thinking, the reason why we thought short, if you remember, is because we were just sitting out way outside the Bollinger Band, and a couple of things are either gonna, a couple of things are gonna happen. Remember, we weren't looking for straight down, we were actually looking for a little bump up first, maybe even a little higher high, and then a drop, and we got what was essentially a double top. And then she came back a little bit for a decent little 100 pip downside trade. But the reason why we talked about that was because this big green candle was completely outside the Bollinger Band. Well, now, now we've slid back inside the daily Bollinger Band, and the 5 has come up close enough that if we were to continue here, the 5 EMA would be drug up to look like we're just riding the 5, so to speak, on these daily candles. So from my standpoint, the daily no longer helps us yet in terms of thinking any kind of more pullback, right? From my perspective, it all looks very much like continuation on the daily. Now the problem is timing this, folks. We don't need, get yourself in, because think about it, if you're not in, somewhere down here in the 127.80s, getting in here seems awfully late looking for, 138.40 as a conservative target. So what I want to do today is just look how we can time this, if we're going to see continuation and if we're going to see a pullback. Okay, one, two scenarios. All right, so let me just show you what's happening on the 2 hour, which is inherently bullish. All right, the 2 hour is held, guys, which we expected, right? We expected that this 2 hour 21 EMA would be a strong force, plus this 40 area swing high. So we're going to use that as a trap for us. If I take you to 15 minute now. All right, and just zoom you out a touch. One more time. Okay, there we go. Like I said before, this 35-30 area has been very tough, 35-40 area, and here we're sitting there again. So my thing is this, guys: if we're going to continue up, then a couple of things. I expect to find a good measure of support around the 60 area, just because of the cluster of EMAs, the central pivot, a few other things in that zone. All right, so that's the first area where I'd look for continuation, plus this little gap close, something like that. All right, however, it's not difficult for us just to trap the top. It's very clear what's going on. We can even move this and slightly manipulate this a little bit so it works for us. There we go. And then we have ourselves a little price trap. And then you have, what is effectively a little 15-minute price trap, and you do nothing inside you until you have a breakout of it. And if we break to the downside, if I really zoom you out there, if we break to the downside, remember we were looking for a fib of this whole rise, okay? And that's going to put us around, 34.50, so a decent amount of pips there. Plus, let's have a look at the 4-hour and see where that corresponds. Yeah, and you can see the 4-hour, zoom in one more time, 4-hour 21 EMA is right there. So, guys, if we're going to break to the downside, that's going to present another golden little buying opportunity. Stay conservative on the short. If a break, pull back, and then short us down there. But, if we're not going to continue up from above this 35.30 area, well, then we're looking for a drop to the 4-hour 21.382 of this last major rise, and that's going to be the next buying opportunity. Looking for 38.40, the upside conservative target. Is that going to happen today? I don't know. It's hard to say, but sooner rather than later would be my expectation, if not all the way into the early 140s. Okay. So just a simple little trap and trade it. And then, our first level that we're looking to get long is around this 35.70 area. And we'll have to see with confirmation if price is going to start heading up from there in alignment with this freshly crossed MACD, which is obviously kind of been artificially crossed given what's happened with the gap Friday, etc. But the 2-hour 21 is held, and that's a quick moving continuation platform to launch from. The same thing with the pound dollar with some very narrow 2-hour Bollinger Bands and a 2-hour 21 bounce. Now the other one I want to look at today very quickly is the pound yen. I'm going to spend about 1 minute on this to keep this video brief, and we'll move on with our day. But if you recall on the pound yen, if I just zoom you out here, this 138 area, guys, has just been the impenetrable wall on and off for the last few days. I mean, really, really tough. We've traded multiple bounces. I'm sorry, let me get my arrow here. We've traded multiple bounces above and below it many, many, many times. Okay, and now if you notice, we just retested it again today. So, you know, my thing is, are we going to see good continuation of the upside? Don't get too excited yet, because we have to break out of this lost little trap. If I splice that in there, you know, and just zoom you in. Okay, we broke out this trend line here, you know, all the way through here, and then effectively retested. This is also the hourly 200 through here, and then broke above 138 and retested. Now I'm bullish as long as we can continue to make these higher highs and higher lows all the way up here. I'm keeping bullish, but we got to break out of this. We've got to break out of this area. So, you know, this, guys, I don't expect a hold here for all the way through London. I absolutely expect this to be a good trade, and then the upside target is 141.60 as an upside target, and if we break back to the downside, you know, in the early 136s. So, you know, a beautiful little breakout type strategy. Remember how to trade your breakout. Wait for a breakout, you wait for your pullback, you know, boom, boom, boom. And keep in mind that if we continue to see good USD correlation, the pound yen is going to be a little bit choppier, all right? The pound is showing some decent relative strength relative to the euro lately, euro pound kind of bouncing off its 4-hour 21 as well. You know, decent relative strength. So, you know, if we're going to see some good upside in the pound yen, it's not going to be a fluid, clean movement that you typically may be used to, given the good USD correlation. Okay, so you know, be a little more thick-skinned with your stop, give a little more room, a little more latitude, trade more of a directional play as opposed to a price type play. I hope that makes some sense. You know, you're more trading the direction of the breakout as opposed to, you know, every individual little, you know, pip movement. All right, so take a bit of a more thick-skinned approach there, maybe lower the lot size, be a little more generous with the stop. All right, this has been your pre-London outlook for March the 23rd, 2009. My name is David Pegler. Have a profitable trading week this week, folks. I'll catch up with you tomorrow.